We'll quickly run through some of these sentences which we did earlier and then try to proceed further. Inverting the spirit's apex towards life, she spent the plastic liberties of the One. She spent the plastic liberties of the One. She, of course, stands for life. Spirit's apex towards life. Spirit can be represented as a double triangle, Satchitananda as a double triangle, descending triangle and ascending triangle, or what we have got in Shivindu's symbol, you see, that is Satchitananda, you see. The descending triangle is the higher entering into the lower. The ascending triangle is the lower climbing up to the higher. And the intersection of these two triangles forms a square. That is a perfect manifestation. Square is a symbol of perfection. In the square, of course, you have got the lotus, the divine consciousness, the divine presence itself, and seven waves of water. Seven planes of consciousness pervading the entire creation. That is what we have got now. Here, what we see is, she stands, of course, for life. She spent the plastic liberties of the One. One has been left undefined. In fact, this One kept undefined like that in number of places. This One is kept, and you have to see this One in different contexts. In the very first canto, One dealt with her. To Savitri, One dealt with her. In the very first canto, we got that thing. Then, of course, One shall descend. That is the famous thing. One shall descend. The Divine Mother is granting a boon to Ashwapati and telling him, One shall descend. She does not say that I will descend, or my form will come down. She does not say that. She says, One shall descend. Now, in a certain sense, that One uses flexibility in interpreting also many times, you see. When One dealt with her, she able to explain that One could be the master of evolution. One dealt with her. Grief, sorrow, suffering, that is what was dealt to Savitri. So that could be the master of evolution. One shall descend. She does not say that I will descend. My form will come down here. In other words, the divine Shakti, the divine power, whom to whom you are praying, it is she who will take a mortal form and come down here. Here, this is a metaphysical term. She spent the plastic liberties of the One, the Satchitananda himself. Here I would refer One standing for Satchitananda himself, you see. Plastic liberty, he has got full freedom. He can do whatever you like, give different shapes, different forms, different configurations. It can bring out completely, you see. She spent. So she is now kind of exploiting the possibilities which are present in that One, in the Satchitananda consciousness, and trying to do something which her will, her desire, her urge drives her towards these things. She spent the plastic liberty, the One, to cast in acts the dreams of her caprice. So whatever she dreams of, whatever she imagines, whatever she envisions, she wants to give them a shape using the powers and possibilities of the One. In other words, she is exploiting that One for her own purposes in a way of speaking. To cast in acts. In fact, that is the most important part. You see, One is there, all the possibilities are there, every potentiality is present there, ideas are there, but then they have not taken shape. They have to be cast into creation, to cast in acts. into action, in dynamics of life, they have to come down here. That is the most important part of it, that bringing down certain things, the dynamics of life, in the operations of life, in the movements of life, is the entire job of life. Ideas, we may have beautiful ideas, but they cannot come into existence unless there is a life force working behind. It is life force which gives concreteness and motivation to ideas in our life, you see. To carve in acts the dreams of our capability, his wisdom, his, of course, once, his wisdom call, steadies her careless feet, careless, well, she doesn't bother. She dances in a very wild way, in a very erratic manner. She doesn't bother at all, see. In fact, that is the liberty, that is the power, that is the nature of life itself. Not to be restrained, not to be confined to any specific rule or regulation, and like that. Do whatever you like. Plunge, do whatever you like, see. Throw yourself into action, irrespective of the consequences. Who bothers about consequences? They'll be taken care of her. So she is a kind of a vivacious lady, and she will do whatever she likes to do. But behind that, there is a steadying wisdom. The steadying wisdom is of his. It is his wisdom which kind of makes it steady, you see. His wisdom's call steadies her careless feet. He props her dance upon a rigid base. A definiteness is what is used, you see. His time is still immutability. His time is still immutability. The quiet, the peace, the frozen, so to say, the frozen approach of his idea. It is that which gives a definite base for our work. His time is still immutability. Still is actually an adjective, is a noun here. Still immutability must standardize her creation's miracle. You see, unless that is done, otherwise it becomes a wild play completely, you see. And therefore, she is allowed to do, she is by nature one such that she can do whatever she will like, without the consequences, without whether it is hazard, whether it is glory or it is fall, whether it is the bitter taste or the sweet taste, she doesn't care at all. She keeps on trying, experimenting, whatever comes in her way, in her mind, in her dream, in her imagination, but to give a certain direction, a certain motivation towards that thing, it is that wisdom which was from behind and steadies her, must standardize. So he says, it is unless that is done, he said no meaning, must standardize her creation's miracle. Yeah, miracle? Yeah, obviously it's a miracle. She can do whatever you like. There is no, she is not going by any textbook. So, whatever comes out is a miracle, you see, that way, you see. That is the nature of the feminine, you see. Out of the voice, unseeing energy. What is she doing now? Out of the voice, unseeing energy. He is referring back now to the beginning of this creation. The poet is referring back to the beginning of this creation. The voice, unseeing, yeah. There is the inconscience, sorry, before the inconscience appears, there is the inconscient self, the slumbering self, and there is the somnambulist force. She walks as if in a dream, constantly, in the night, constantly. Now, those are the energies which are present there in the void itself, inventing the scene of a concrete universe. In fact, that is how it has happened. It started coming up from the inconscient energies, the whole creation. By his thought, she has fixed his species. By his thought of the one, she has fixed, again, life force, his species of this universe. In his blind acts, she sees the flashes of his all-knowing light. She sees, well, she has no idea, she is not seeing at all. Sometimes there are kind of flashes, and from those flashes, she knows how to move. Flashes of his all-seeing light, all-knowing light, at a will. See, I mean, what a wonder. Because she can do whatever she likes, and she is allowed to do that kind of a thing, to do that thing, at a will. the inscrutable supermind leans down. That is a great thing she is doing. See, in order to give some sense of a direction and a purpose, some aim to her movement, supermind kind of intervenes. When she is working here, she knows that she is not able to see that thing. Therefore, she asks the help from supermind, and supermind obliges. At her will, the supermind leans down to oblige her, to respond to her, to guide her force that fails but cannot know. The force cannot know because there is no knowledge there, but there is an action only all the while. In order to give some sort of a direction to that, to know where things are moving, she summons the supramental help, the help of supermind, you see, and supermind obliges her, you see, to guide her, force that feels but cannot know. Its breadth of power controls the restless sea, and life obeys the governing idea. Therefore, life obeys the idea coming from supermind. Yes, go by this, do that thing, like that sort of a thing, you see. At her will, led by luminous eminence, the hazardous experimenting mind. Pushes its way through obscure possible mid-chance formations of an unknowing world. Experimenting mind keeps on trying all kind of ideas, and because it is experimenting, you have got chance formations of unknowing world. Chance form. This will happen, that will happen by chance, because it is experimenting all kind of things. Now, this experimentation of the mind is guided by a luminous eminence. The experimentation of mind is guided by a luminous eminence. There is somebody very close to you, and you are allowed to do things, you are experimenting it. That is, unless you allow that kind of freedom, it may be wrong, it may be good, or it may be bad. Unless you allow that freedom, things cannot move forward. So the immanence is allowing this sort of a thing. At a will, that is possible because she allows that thing to. At a will, the supermind comes down. At a will, the experimenting mind bids possible forms, you see. The creation of form is the action of mind, idea, mind, idea. It is the idea that gives a shape and a form, finally, you see, in sequence of things. So, the formation belongs to mind, in that sense, you see. At a will, led by a luminous eminence, obviously, it's a divine illumination, divine power, obviously. So, it is the supermind which is coming down. It is the luminous eminence which is guiding the experimenting mind, and all these things are happening at her will. She allows that thing because she knows that she has to depend upon her. And as a result of this, all the eminence, all the experimenting mind, all the supermind coming down, our human ignorance moves towards the truth. Otherwise, we would have been stuck, would have remained where we are, where we were, you see. Our human ignorance moves towards the truth, that nations may become omniscient. So there is a kind of a logic behind the whole operation, you see. Ultimately, from nations, you have to move towards omniscience. From nothing, you have to bring out a manifestation. You have to move that way, you see. Our human ignorance moves towards the truth, that nations may become omniscient. Transmuted instincts shaped to divine thought. That is the progress we are making. Our instincts are now becoming divine thoughts. You see, thoughts house infallible immortal sight, and nature climb towards God's identity. So she has really achieved something great by willing that supermind should enter in, by willing that the experimenting mind should be led by the illumination. She has achieved something, that nature is climbing towards God's identity. From nothing, she is able to build up this hierarchy of jobs.